Now let's work on the front emblem. We're going to take off the whole grill first. So you have four of the Torx 25 on top. I'll get those four out right on top here. Now to get this out, you're just going to pull, but you can get a little sticky under here, right where these mesh. This side always comes out good for me. This side always gets sticky. So kind of get under these vertical slats here. It's kind of scary. You don't want to crack it. This corner over here gets stuck. So sometimes I'll push down on the bumper. If you see the clips, that's kind of the way you need to do it. And there we go. So if it's stuck, you push down on the bumper, but not on this. And it pushes away. You see how this works. So you have these clips under here, which go into these tiny little slats. And those slats come up from the bottom. So when you're pushing it down, you're trying to push that nub out of the slat so you can pull it out. So that's just a little tip there. Put pressure downward if any of these clips won't come out. So that's the first step. The entire grill is off. Now, I've never taken this off myself. Look, I can see a couple little slits here. One there that you kind of have to pry off. I probably need to really use my full attention to get this. Let me go ahead and get it off and then I'll come back to you. I've spent so long on this trying to get this thing apart. I've read like 10 DIYs on forums, all kinds of different years. Some have melted tabs, and I finally found a correct DIY for this 13, which is to separate the gloss and the matte to really get it properly. And this itself has taken me 30 minutes at least. Still working on these bottom clips here. It's super hard. I mean, I can't believe how hard they made it. This does not have a twisty, nice, simple setup like some of the older ones. They must have changed it later because people maybe were stealing them or something. I don't know. So still working on getting these tabs out. Then I can finally get the emblem out and do some work. I finally got it. Amazingly, I didn't break any clips. And I was pulling super hard and prying for like 30 minutes solid. So that just tells you these clips are strong. You can break them, but they're pretty strong. Now I can see what people are talking about. See that little arrow? You got to lift these tabs up outward there, like past that little nudge, and then you can probably twist it. But see, once you twist it and it goes up this ledge and snaps into place, so you got to release these clips upward toward the edge. And then when you do all three, then you can finally twist it and take out your emblem. I finally got it. I twisted it out of those holders there. Then I can push in these clips and just push it right out of the hole. It's going to take two hands. This front emblem now has three coats of black. I'm just waiting to do one final coat of clear. Turned out pretty good, in my opinion. Real smooth. A couple tiny dots there, but I'm not perfect. It's as good as it's going to get. Nice side coverage, too. Just finished my third black gloss and my second clear. I had to redo this whole thing over. I was putting on my last coat of clear when you last on this last frame you just saw, and I put on a hair too much. I got greedy and I got it all bubbled, and I had to strip the whole thing again. That took like an hour in itself trying to get all these cracks. This is the second go round. Again, I have three coats of black, just laid my second coat of clear, and I think it's just about done. So now I'm going to wait for it to dry, and I finally get to reinstall it. I'm trying to give you some different light angles. Looks really good. I like it a lot. Really smooth looking. Just got the grill reassembled. It was a lot easier. And disassembly, of course. Let's go ahead and try this out. And the final look. I love it. It kind of reminds me of the Batmobile for some strange reason.